So, why are four TV presenters battling it out in the middle of the Canadian Rockies?
Perhaps we should explain a little about the battle of the sexes that is Bring It On.
For the past 6 months, the boys, that's us, have been demonstrating our superior skills in a set of challenges. We've shown our dominance in everything from being comedians to birdmen.
In your dreams, the girls' challenges were harder and we won more than you.
No, you didn't.
No, I'm not listening because you're talking rubbish.
There is probably only one way to settle this dispute, with the help of Special Forces survival expert, Ken Haynes.
Morning, everybody.
Morning.
Hello.
How are you?
Not too bad.
Freezing, well, but all right.
Freezing?
I'm Rich.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, yeah. Dom. You all right?
Dom, who's the
Hi,
you?
I'm Fran. Hi.
Hi, Fran.
Hi, Anya.
Hi, Anya. How are you? Well, I've come up with this fantastic plan to test your teamwork and your commitment to the limit. And I've devised a series of winter survival challenges to test you both physically and mentally. And what we're trying to do is answer that big question. In the world of Bring It On, who's the best? The boys or the girls?
We are.
Yes, thank you. Yes.
No, we are.
We are.
For our first challenge, Ken took us to meet husky expert Connie Arsenault, who is going to teach us how to work and race with a team of dogs.
So, today what we're going to do is teach you about the different breeds of dogs because you will be required to pick your teams. Each dog, like humans, have their own individual characteristics. And when you put those characteristics together on your team, that will determine whether you win or lose.
So it's not just colour coordinated?
No. I'm glad you pointed that out. In anything in life, looks can only get you so far.
They're all beautiful, so.
I think this one
wants to be picked by us.
When we're training our huskies this time of year, we actually use an ATV quad, a four-wheel drive little vehicle. It's quite fun.
Okay.
So you girls get first pick.
I don't know.
I think he looks a bit slow.
But I love him because he's old.
Oh no, but love's not always enough.
Okay, basically, let's be ruthless.
That one.
Speed.
Okay.
Brico, good
right,
choice.
You're
with us, baby.
So you can choose Apache or Axel.
I think Axel
would
be a good look at him.
Another breed of Arctic Husky.
Powerful dog.
Okay, you guys are very perceptive.
They're going out together. Let's keep them together.
You get Clover.
Clover.
Oh, we got this one.
All right, son. Right, let's harness up the big boy. This is Axel.
Axel looks like a bit of a...
tough man.
Yeah, a bit of a tough one, so...
Right, Axel, Dom is now going to straddle you.
Hello, sweetheart. Hello. Do you know what I'm going to do?
Cross towards you.
Hey.
Calm him down. Come on. Showing his master.
Hey. Excited to go running? Or not really, not bothered. Done it a million times.
No, stop.
Like that,
stop. That's it, with the cross towards you.
Oh,
excited
that looks
race.
A bit wrong.
It's like that.
That's it.
No.
No, it's wrong.
All right, boys,
You're
first. Let's start with our leaders. Remember, we always put our leaders in first.
Good dog.
Hi.
Come on away.
For the competition, Ken was timing us over a measured course with one turnaround where we could swap with our team partner.
Absolutely amazing.
Come on!
fine. Yeah.
Okay. Keep going, man.
Go, Poncho, Maxine.
Okay?
You're doing good. You're doing fine. Hold on. Okay, the next driver. Hi.
Go, go, go. Miss, miss, miss. Come on, TD.
I've got to say, they're doing it pretty quickly.
Going very quick, faster than us, I reckon.
I think they've got a bunch of mad dogs.
Miss, miss, come on, TD.
Results, haven't we, Connie?
We sure do.
And the race was really, really close. The boys went first, 2 minutes, 12 seconds, and 49 hundredths. Okay, well done. Good effort.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Followed very closely by the girls in 2 minutes, 12 seconds, and 59 hundredths.
Oh, wow.
Boys actually
very
won
close.
The race by 10 hundredths of a second.
And they had worse dogs.
Yeah.
But that's not all, Connie.
So can you give us the scores, please? Connie?
Yes, actually, out of 10, we have decided, with all of the criteria taking it into consideration, the boys won 9 out of 10. Congratulations. And the girls are 7 out of 10.
Oh,
great,
yeah.
Great effort.
Fair enough. Though. Fair enough.
Ken decided we needed a bit of training to learn how to get around in the mountains.
Snowshoeing was easy, but other methods of getting about proved slightly trickier.
You idiot!
Now, out in the woods, I found a friendly Canadian here. Hi, Dave.
Hi, Dave.
Hello.
Hi.
All right.
Dave's going to be helping us today, giving you some expert coaching on moving cross-country on your skis. Yeah, just spread out a little bit, yeah?
No, we've got to be next to each other for safety reasons.
Sort it out.
Too far forward. Too far back.
Yeah. Whoa!
Whoa! Push.
Oh, up, up!
Hey!
Yeah. Oh, I nearly did the split!
Here, and we're working
no.
on the OK, now push out, push out, push out!
Okay. Yes! Don't fall over again.
And then there was orienteering, or as we call it, getting lost.
What we want to do is find out how many paces you take for 100 metres. Set me bearing and point in the right direction that you're going to walk of 170 degrees.
That way.
And then...
Got to move that.
That to... There, isn't it?
Yeah. So it's that way.
Now, who's facing the right way here? Okay.
I
think well done. You're pointing exactly the right direction that way.
Yeah.
You stupid cunt.
You're pointing exactly the wrong direction.
For our challenge that day, Ken told us that he wanted us to spend a night alone in the woods to learn some survival skills.
Oh look! Yeah, oh look! Oh.
And first up was making fire.
It's freezing.
We've got to make, we've got to make holes in that first, so. Go on, Fran. I'll hold it. You give it what you've got.
Yeah. You might get...
Yeah. It takes me back to my scout days. All right. And these are ready.
Let me have a go,
No, hang on, I'm nearly there now.
Go on, one more. That's it. Give it another one. Yeah. No, 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 let's just stick some more of that. Get it really good.
Yes!
Well done.
Move away.
Yeah, I know, I can hold a bit of cotton wool.
That's what I was thinking.
Why don't I do that?
It's a bit dangerous, though.
It's cold now. Is it going to get colder?
It will get colder. It's quite warm at the moment.
Is
it going to drop
warm?
To about, I don't know, minus 15 tonight?
What?
Snuggle up together, because body heat is the best thing in a cold climate to keep you warm. All right, so if you snuggle up together,
you mean,
you'll be nice and warm.
No, he
snuggle
doesn't.
Up together?
No.
Oh, okay.
With the girls? Or?
He definitely doesn't.
You'll be fine.
Right.
Okay, let's crack on then.
So I think if we make this bit really flat...
The girls and boys are down in their camp.
and they're getting their water boiling and getting their tea on. But what they don't know is they're actually not going to stay out tonight. But before I go, I'm going to give them this little camera and they're going to be able to record their thoughts and their feelings and how they think they're getting on. I'm going to then come back and say, right, there's a wild cat out in the woods. We've got to get out of here quickly. They'll then have to pack all their kit and then follow me back down to the car park. Now I'll be marking them on how well they get themselves organised and, of course, whether they bring all their kit back.
Well, we've made the fire.
Yeah.
We flattened the snow, made our camp bed. All you do is make a bit of food.
And then try and sleep.
I'm actually a little bit scared out here because we thought everyone was joking, all the people that came with us, like Ken and stuff.
They've just gone.
But now they're actually gone. And listen, if you listen carefully, you can't hear anything. We're actually more scared than the girls. But we'll never let them know that.
What's your favourite of the wild animals that could eat us?
If I had to be eaten by a wild animal, I think I'd like to be eaten by maybe maybe a grizzly bear.
Can we come and sit with you boys?
Yeah. But we're just going to put our food on now.
What's on the menu tonight, Richard?
I'll tell you, Fran. On the menu tonight is dehydrated Texas chili and rice.
Delicious! My tummy's excited already.
You are welcome to the best restaurant in town. Look at that. Yes, spot on.
You see, I think if you respect the forest and the mountains, then I think it won't kill you.
Try telling a bear that as it's ripping your throat out.
Thing is, there is four of us.
Yeah. So what?
Oh yeah, so we'd be able to wrestle the
bear. And a 12-foot bear, made of muscle, with claws like...
What's that?
Who's that? Get that whistle.
If I see something, I'm going to die.
Shh.
Listen carefully, okay? We've just had a report of a cougar up on the track. Get everything together and then move up onto the track and join me, okay?
I think we'll have to done in 30 seconds if I get my way.
What does a cougar look like if I see it?
Can you put the plastic stuff in?
Okay.
I need the knife, mate, the knife.
And the rucksack.
Where's the rucksack? Right. Girls, you got it all?
That was a quick get out.
Okay. Okay, boys. Right, I think we're done, Ken.
All right, let's check through your stuff, innit?
Two bottles of water each.
Yep, yeah, you've all got those, haven't you? Yep.
One neck band. Yep. Well, two.
Two neck bands.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
I've
got those.
Two sunglasses and cords, yeah, down the front.
OK.
There's the whistle. No.
Really, really was nicely laid out and good effort. OK, girls, how are we doing?
I don't know.
OK, I
all right. So we've got two survival rations.
Yes.
One there, where's the other one?
Yeah, where's the other one?
In here.
Is it?
No, I was just making that up.
Big survival ration. Check your sacks, Vicky.
No.
I've
only got one.
Okay, one survival ration missing. Okay.
Quite important.
Very important. Very well done on the survival challenge.
Cheers.
Excellent effort. But of course, I've got to score you on how you did. Boys, very well organised. Nice action around the camp. Got yourselves sorted out pretty quickly. Well done.
Cheers.
Girls, I struggled a little bit with the fire,
but
did persevere.
Yeah.
You tried really, really hard and kept going at it, which is the main thing in survival. Now, on the scoring, I'm going to give the boys
9
out of 10.
Cheers.
And girls, I'm going to give you 7 out of 10.
Next day, we were really up the creek as Ken took his ice climbing.
Oh, there we are.
I feel a bit sorry for him.
What?
I know we're going to win it. Well, I reckon we're going to win it. Yeah. You never know. But, yeah, I reckon the girls will pull back at something. But they haven't got that.
It's boy power. You know what I mean, lads?
Yeah. Hopefully, I thought today's the day the girls come out on top, not just in the mountain, but of the whole competition caboodle. But actually, having seen that...
No way.
Hi, Brian. Nice to see you again. How are you?
See you. Good, good, good.
Hiya. Everybody, this is Barry.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Barry.
Hi. Hi. Now, okay. Barry's going to be teaching us how to ice climb today. So, Barry, what's the first step?
Well, the first step will be to get our equipment on, harnesses, crampons, ice axes, and then we'll start learning how to use it all.
The waist buckle should be closing on the left side on this harness, and you check out your partner's harness.
But can you check them rather than us?
Next thing we're gonna learn is to try to keep these things into the ice and out of the body. This is maybe the first time in your life you've had 100% traction. Walk like a cowboy. Don't let your feet get too close together. What I want you to do is use these things as handholds and just practice going across here.
That's it. Good kicking.
Okay, good, good. I'm just here spotting you. Good.
My arm next.
Yep.
All right.
Pull two down.
Yeah, solid.
Cut both of their wrist loops on. Hold these things up over your head like this. Full arms reach. And just try one hand at a time.
I have absolutely no control over my wrists.
Put the hand right at the bottom of the table.
Oh, ow! Yeah.
Cool.
Wow.
Oh, I got ice down the front. That's not
stand up. I'll stand down.
You can see on the ice wall behind me a number of ice screws going up the face. Now, for each ice screw that you pass with the end of your axes, you can get 1 point. And if you tap those two carabiners at the top with your ice axe, you can get 2 bonus points. Okay, and Anya, I think you're gonna go first.
Bring it on! I'm ready. Okay. Nice and safe, please.
Let's climb.
Okay. Go, Anya! Go, Anya! Go, Anya! Go, Anya!
Get in.
Good.
Yes.
Nice, Fran.
Look at that ice shattering.
Ice.
Oh.
Oh. That's man.
Good. Good.
Look at it.
Leave some ice for Fran, yeah, Dom?
Bunk. Sinker.
Good hold, put it.
Oh!
It's not all about brute force, you know.
Let's see how it's good.
Ice. 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 Ice here.
Thank you. Yay!
Excellent.
Rock on!
Just to bug you now, do it. Oh. Careful.
Well done, good effort. Well done.
Bring it!
Doing it! I've got it!
Well done, good.
Woo-hoo. Ding, ding!
Well done.
Ding, ding! And the girls are back in play!
Well, it's time for the scores. But Barry, can you tell us how the teams did today?
Well, I think you guys all did fantastic. You're really good, quick study in ice climbing. I think the gentlemen, and this is really typical of first-time climbers, started to lean on the strength, whereas the ladies remained with balance. When we did the competition, everyone topped out, got 7 points each, team scores of 14, but I think the ladies were a little better balanced on their feet and a little more delicate, and they're gonna get 3 extra points for it.
Oh, man.
Less force in the future and more finesse, and you'll
so
be
you
there.
So you mean more brain, less brawn?
Exactly.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
Final race day, and it was going to be winner takes all for the first team to finish.
And as the boys led by 1 point, they were to get a 10-second head start.
We can't do one!
Now we've got the big race for you to finish off. And I've got Barry and Dave here with me to help me judge.
Barry, Dave, I love you, and Ken.
Stop it, Jesus.
We're girls.
So there'll be a bit of snowshoeing, some orienteering, some firelighting, and finishing off with some skiing.
That's all right.
So the boys are going to get a 10-second start.
That's all right.
Not off.
So are you ready?
Yep.
Yes! Yeah.
Come on.
Bring it on.
Boys, stand by. 3, 2, 1, go!
Push the tempo, push the tempo, push the tempo.
Girls, stand by. 3, 2, 1, go! Good luck.
Drop on quick, you fool!
No!
Come on! Put it back on! Come on!
Help! Ah, my chin!
Come on!
Ow!
Come on!
Ow.
Right, go! Right, oh!
Hey, boys. Hold on, hang on. I'm going to give you instructions for your orienteering, OK?
Yeah.
Come on!
No, wait,
that's the wrong one!
Make sure you got the right one, haven't you?
Oh, hang on a minute,
come on.
This is hardly fair!
Cheat! Cheat, Ken!
Ken had placed all the things we needed to make fire and melt snow in the forest.
And all we had to help us find the stuff was a compass.
Ah, oh dear.
This way. Ready?
Yeah.
Go.
No, but where? Point the arrow in the right direction. Reset it!
Shut your face!
Reset it! Yes!
Oh, genius!
Yes, I got it!
Right! Stop! Run! You go back! Go back! Run, run, run!
1, 2...
20, 21...
I can see it!
Wow!
I see it! Here it is!
There it is! Wood! Let's go!
And by the way, Richard...
Yeah?
Did you take your pack with you?
No.
No? Well... Quick. I'm afraid I'm awarding you a penalty.
Penalty?
A penalty, and that's to wear the shower cap.
Thank you. Are you joking?
No, I'm not.
Oh, man. Whoa! No way.
Come on, girls, they're only just in front of you.
Right, do that funny walk. Yep. Gonna do a stop here. Not like that.
No, you're skiing well, you're getting some glide.
Stop. The blue pack, I've got it, the wood. Let's go.
Using all the fire-making materials, we had to melt a tin full of snow.
But as we knew, making a fire is actually a whole lot harder than it looks.
All right, got it. Careful.
It's gone out, it's going out.
No, it's not. That's a life. No.
Look at that. Really stoking up.
Whoa.
Doing it.
Oh no, my hair.
Right, okay, let's be efficient. I'm going to put all the stuff away from when we're finished.
Yeah, that's melted. It's right.
No, grab all of this.
I've got it.
Grab this. I've got it. Shut up. Go.
Careful of your eyebrows. You're going to see all of them work.
Dom, you know what we didn't do?
What?
Pick up the mess tin.
Do we have to pick it up?
No, leave it. We didn't tell us
no,
to.
No, I'm going
to
get it.
Forget it.
No.
Oh. Okay, that looks good to me.
Yes, do we need to take it with us?
No. Well, you idiot! You dare lose it now, Dom! Go!
Oh, no!
What's going on? We're nearly there!
Beat him, go on!
Yes!
Perfect!
Come on!
Perfect!
One!
Well done, girls.
Well done. Oh.
Yeah! Whoa!
Well done. What do you think, guys?
Pretty darn good. I think you put a good effort in over the days. I'd almost say we could make you an honorary Canadians.
Come on.
I'll echo that. I was impressed with your ice climbing yesterday. You came a long way in a short time.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
So now,
you ready for some more pain?
What?
You ready for some more pain?
No, never.
What do you mean?
You're joking, aren't you?
Why?
I thought we might go for a run or something, no?
Shut up!
Get Come on!